All right, so there are three main topics that are related to matrices on the ACT. Luckily, there aren't a lot of matrix questions, but there are a couple, and really you only need to know the basics. So if you can master these three basic concepts, you're actually probably going to get these questions correct. It's actually not a super advanced topic. So first one is you have to know how to do matrix addition and subtraction. Luckily, those are effectively the same. It's just like any time you're doing addition and subtraction, it's just when you're adding, you're going to add. When you're subtracting, you're going to subtract. So let's just take a look at the first one here, this matrix addition. What you'll see is I have two matrices here, the one that starts with AB in the top row and then GH in the second row. So in order to perform matrix addition, what you do is you take your first position, so we could say first row, first column, and you're just going to add that to the first position of your second matrix. So again, first row, first column. So you'll see here, then in your resultant matrix, which is what you get after you perform addition, you would just add those together to get A plus G. And then you'll see it's really straightforward, same thing. Basically, here, this would be second row, first column. Again, on your second matrix, second row, first column, you just add those together and you'll put the result there. And then you continue through. Same thing for subtraction, except for obviously you would be subtracting, as an example, A and G to get this position rather than adding. So that's the first concept. Again, pretty straightforward, nothing crazy. Second topic is scalar multiplication. Scalar in this case just means a constant. So you'll see here n would be our scalar, and that's just going to be any number. So it could be 3, 5, whatever. And then here is your matrix. And then you'll see to perform scalar multiplication, all you do is you take your constant and you multiply it by each one of these terms. And so you'll see in our resultant matrix over here, we have n times a in our first position, n times b in our second, n times c, and so on. That is the second topic. And sometimes questions will actually combine these. So you may have to actually multiply by a scalar and then add two matrices, for example. We'll get into some practice problems like that a bit later. And then the third topic is matrix multiplication. This is probably the most complicated topic that you're going to see when it comes to matrices, but luckily it's really not that bad. You'll see the basic equation is here, and you'll see basically the steps in this resultant matrix here. So you can see what you're doing is you're doing A times G, and I'm talking about all to get this position to start. So you do A times G plus B times, let me see if I can get that to work. B times I plus C, nope, it's not working with me. So you guys are going to just have to bear with me. Anyways, plus C times K. So that's to get the upper left hand here. That's to get this one. Then we can move on and we can do this one here. So now we're doing the same thing, except for starting in our top row. Now we're working through our second row. So we're doing D times G plus E times I plus F times K. Then we're moving over here. Now we're going back to our first column, but then we're multiplying by our second row. So we're doing A times H plus B times J plus C times L. Then for our last one here, we're doing second row times second column. So D times H plus E times J plus F times L. So it's kind of similar. Basically, you just have to remember to do all of an entire row times all of an entire column. And of course, add those together. So it's like, you're multiplying each position and then adding the subsequent positions. We'll go over some practice problems like that here in the next, coming minutes. The key thing to know is that there's a couple shortcuts that you can use to help yourself do process of elimination and narrow down your choices. And also, you're really not going to have to go through the entire matrix multiplication. Anyways, we'll talk more about that later, but just know it's nothing crazy. you're basically only going to have 2 by 2 matrices. And even then, usually, if you can just figure out what this first one is, you're going to be able to find the correct answer choice. Couple other notes on matrix multiplication. There's a couple important things to note. You are going to have to check the dimensions of your matrix prior to multiplying. So you'll see here we have rows by columns, right? M by N and then N by P. And what happens is these inner numbers here, or I guess dimensions here, these have to be equal. If they're not, your matrix product is undefined. If you'd like to prove that to yourself, you can. Basically, just practice doing matrix multiplication with two matrices that where that isn't the case, where these don't match, and you'll see why. I'm not going to go into that. I'm just going to ask you to take my word for it. Basically, know these have to match or else it's undefined. That's something to always check prior to performing matrix multiplication, right? Because otherwise, you're just going to waste your time just to get an undefined product. Last thing, whatever these things are here on the outside, these are going to give you the dimensions of your resultant matrix. This is again another really easy way to use process of elimination for matrix questions. You can narrow down your answer choices just by knowing what the dimensions of your resultant vector are going to be. So again, it's actually going to matter in what order you multiply the matrix. If you do A times B, that can actually be different than B times A. Last topic you're going to need to know is these just call it matrix equations. Basically, it's when you take a coefficient matrix and you multiply it by a variable matrix, and you're going to get a constant matrix. I'm kind of being imprecise in my speech. Really, all you need to know for the ACT is you basically just need to know how to model a system of linear equations using this setup. So, basically, again, we could perform matrix multiplication, which would be this row times this column, right? And then you'll kind of see it here. The 5 times the x gives you the 5x here. And then the -4 times the y gives you the -4y here, and then it's going to equal 8, right? Your constant, which is going to be here. Again, don't have to know that much about it. It's pretty straightforward. I mean, even if you just kind of like look through here, right? Even just the 5, -4, and the 8, it's pretty easy, in my opinion, just to kind of figure that out. But yeah, we'll talk a little bit more about that later as well.